Easy crappie on the fall. Wow, look at that, going along fishing shorelines for pre-spawners. Whew. This episode, we've got something that will definitely help you catch more crappie and add more variety to the ways you catch crappie, and that's with little paddle tail baits. We've got some different baits to show you, some with little rib bodies and a little bit thicker profiles, and of course, the new crappie magnet little dancer. Different scenarios from catching them early spring, before they spawn, post-spawn, late fall, and you name it, any other time of the year that you want to catch crappie and add some variety to your crappie skills and crappie tactics, the new little paddle baits sensation, and it's very similar to fishing like for walleye and bass, where you can cast them, drift them, slow hop them, drag them, glide them, whichever way you want to fish with your little paddle baits, I guarantee you they will entice crappie to bite. So check out some of these segments we have, different scenarios, different times of year, I'm sure you will consider the little paddle baits. All right, the first segment, pre-spawn. You know, just a few days ago, buddy Josh McCain and I are looking for the crappie along the shoreline. They're not there yet. Water temperatures are still in the high 50s. They're not ready to go, but could they be staging? We'll find out. But the thing is, we stuck with a game plan, little paddle tail baits. Could have picked up a float, could have played around with different little jerk baits and different things. We didn't want to. We wanted to see, let's see how many fish we can catch with the paddle tail baits. So we picked up the ones with a little bit thicker body, with a rib, matched it with different tiny jig heads that Josh makes. And let me tell you about something about jig heads. These right here, you gotta see this right here. See that right there? Josh makes these, custom makes these right here to specifications that we want to fish crappie, walleye, bass, you name it. Custom colors to match the different bodies of the soft plastics. And I'm telling you, man, we caught them out deep suspended. We caught them along shorelines. But the key is picking up a bait, something different, having faith in it, and just fishing it. Dude, honestly, right there. Oh, attaboy. I missed mine, Josh. Josh, look. How many are here? Look. Dude, I watched them eat it. I watched them eat it, dude.
So much fun, eh?
Bingo! Paddle bait below the boat.
I want them coming up here again.
I watched them come up and inhale the bait. That is incredible. All right, what about color options? This is the thing I'm going to say about color. Whatever you pick that gives you confidence is the color you should use. Yes, you watch YouTube videos, you're fishing with buddies and stuff, and you get inspired by different colors, but whatever gives you instinct and helps you catch crappie is the key to catching more crappie. But here's a scenario. There's two of you in the boat. Before you figure out exactly what they want and what the aggressiveness of the fish, sometimes it's smart to use offsetting colors, okay? Brights with neutrals and naturals and stuff, just to see what the fish want. When they show you they want a certain color, hey man, put down that rod, pick up another rod, tie in the same bait as your buddy. Don't have any shame, seriously. You both decided that you're both gonna fish that for crappie that day, enjoy the day. But man, oh man, sometimes until you find the real color, try that, you know, offsetting tones, offsetting colors, until you find which works, so it'll help you guys put more fish in the boat.
Good. Well, that's decent fish.
That's an absolute blast. They're just down there. You're going to get hit any second again. Just a fun time with Carl. They're going crazy underneath the boat right now. This is insane. Exactly.
We see all those little ones that like to sit in the tree.
Okay, we caught a bunch of fish on that deep structure, okay? But something about pounding shorelines. You know, I'm a bassaholic. I love to pound the shorelines. So we went along shoreline edges, which were the lips of them. So we'd find different areas. If you see shorelines, it dictates a lot what the temperature or the depths are gonna be out from the shorelines. So you find really hard sloping shorelines with hills and mountains and things like that. Those potentially are gonna have a closer taper to deeper water. Crappie. I'll come on your side, Josh. Nice one.
Nice one, buddy.
Cast along the shoreline on the lip. That was on the lip, Josh. Oh, wow. Like out from shore, eh? Hey, little swim bait, paddle bait, catching crappies along the shoreline. Oof. Some lakes, they like that long beachy area and stuff like that. But again, it's relevant to where you're fishing, whether it be in Alabama, Tennessee, Oklahoma, Ontario, Quebec, doesn't matter where crappie are. You gotta figure out where they're gonna spawn, then stay out from that kind of stuff if they're not spawning yet.
The crappie?
Right. Oh yes.
Atta boy, Josh.
Soft bite on that guy though. Catching them. Rattletails.
We found lips between 8 to 12 feet of water that just tapered down, not much structure there, just had faith that some of those bigger crappie were thinking about going in close, and we called them ghosts and scouts, the ones that go in first. Throwing this little bait, counting down and just slowly working it back with a hop and drop little technique, it caught crappie for us. Crappie, good one too. I let it fall, Josh. Oh, on that deep lip, buddy. The deep lip. Wow.
There we go.
Look at that. A little swim bait, huh? Whew, look at it where he took it. On the fall too. Easy crappie. On the fall. Wow. Look at that. Going along fishing shorelines for pre-spawners. Whew. A little bait. And that little jig. I gotta show you this after, man. At that. I asked Josh make up some nice green ones and stuff. Tell me that's not a nice jig head, boy. Northern Tackle Supply, boy. Honest to goodness, boy. Any color you want under the rainbow, he can make them for you. You gotta get them because, boy, when I wasn't paying attention like that one and that fish bites, you gotta make sure the tools are right, like the rod, line, jig, bait. Put them in the box, take some pictures. We'll let them go. You know what the key was today to having fun? Is sticking to the game plan. You know, we could have changed it up, thrown floats, jerk bait, different baits, you know what I mean? But come on, sometimes about life, change it up, boys. You know what I mean? A restaurant has all different food on a menu. Why is that? Because nobody wants to eat the same food every day. Seriously? Chicken McNuggets all the time? You gotta change it up, okay? Come on, something else. Maybe burgers, I don't know, something else, you know? Shrimp on a stick, who knows? But the key is changing it up. Having fun. So we stuck with the paddle baits, see what we can catch. It taught us to just move around a bit more, be versatile, change our cadence, slow, fast, above, low, deep, you name it. But sticking with the paddle tail baits helped us catch some crappie, and I know it will for you too. This next segment brings us down to the deep south, Alabama, Pickwick Lake. You all know it. Fishing with a good friend, Roger Stegall. Roger guides full-time, I don't know, man, three quarters of his life. The guy knows the lakes inside out, how to catch bass. When it comes to crappie, the guy just knows how to find them. So he invited me down. We picked up again the little paddle tail baits and we just tight lined them, which means we cast out, let it fall on a controlled fall, which means not a lot of slack in the line, so you can see when this bait's falling, very similar to walleye fishing with grubs. You watch that and wait for the tick, or the line tightening up, or your line going to the side, one way or the other. So Pickwick Lake with Roger Stegall, the paddle tail baits, helped us catch crappie, and I know you're gonna buy some when you watch this. On Pickwick Lake, out of Muscle Shoals, Alabama, with my good friend, Roger Stegall. Roger guides full-time for bass, stripers, crappie, you name it. But this time of year, when the crappie are plentiful, they're biting, they're everywhere, he knows where to find them, he knows how to catch them. So we came down here to have some fun in good old Sweet Home, Alabama, catch some crappie, meet some good people, have some good times, just like we always do in the Deep South. So sit back, enjoy, and we'll show you how Pickwick Lake is a place you should consider when you want to go crappie fishing in the spring, summer, fall, winter, it doesn't matter. Whenever you want to go, Muscle Shoals, Alabama is waiting for you.
What we're going to do today is we're going to fish for some crappie. And the way I fish for crappie is a lot like I'm bass fishing. We're going to be casting little 8th ounce and 16th ounce jigs, just tight lining. And I think we'll catch some fish today. We got water rising. As you can see out in the lake, it's trash everywhere. But I think we should have a good day. We've been catching a lot of crappie and be a good time to fish today.
How about color-wise and stuff, Roger? Did it make a big difference?
We got clouds right now, and the chartreuse does better right now. Chartreuse in red, solid chartreuse, chartreuse glitter, some of the tuxedo colors, chartreuse in black, pink and black. Those colors are real good.
Right on. Okay, let's have some fun.
Try that one, and I'm going to try the
okay.
Same color. All right, you'll cast him out there. Let it go all the way to the bottom. When it goes slack, you know you're on the bottom. And then you start reeling it real slow like this. And you stop it, let it fall back. When it line goes slack again, you know it's on the bottom. And you reel it again until you go slack.
And usually they're there, thump, or they're just there, right?
When it's falling, it'll go thump. Or your line will just tighten up, or you'll see your line go to moving off to the side. There's two or three different ways that they'll bite it. But the ideal situation is when you stop it, he goes thump. You see your line jump. I mean, it'll jump when he gets it.
Here we are, right there.
There you go, right there.
Right there, Roger. Boy, he thumped that
good
too.
Deal.
Oh, nice crappie too. Look at that.
Put them in the boat.
Wow, look at them colors on that thing. That didn't take
what
long.
About that? That's about your third cast, wasn't it?
Does Roger know where to go? You're right. It wasn't leaving in a thump either. It was all of a sudden he's just there.
And it's there. Dunk. That's right.
You know? Nice crappie.
They'll thump it sometimes.
That's a nice way to start, huh?
Shower rain.
Now is Pickwick on right away, but a little bit of drizzle and rain, who cares? I got rain gear. Roger's got rain gear. We're going to try to catch some crappie and have some fun and then eat them later. Come on, crappie. Come on, crappie.
We
just sitting all over this
one.
Flat, eh?
We might catch one out of here while we're being movie stars.
How many years now have you been guiding now?
Starting my 28th year.
Wow.
We could go out right there, see that dot right there, and we might catch one. I got something that feels soft there. Feels like line. Pop it like that right there if you don't get it. Feels like it might be on some line. But take it like this, pop it like that, and it come right loose. Magical hands. That's what a boy told me one day. Had magical hands.
Thanks, Roger.
Come on now, crappie.
Nice when you feel that little thump or the weight.
Got him.
Oh, yeah.
That's a good crappie.
Yep.
I think that's the bass fisherman.
Look where you got it.
Crappie.
Identical to the other one, huh?
Yep. Mm-hmm.
I must have landed close to this one's head, Roger, because as soon as it went down.
You got it.
Ooh, Nick, that's a little bit of weight on them.
Yeah, that's a good crappie.
Pan-sized.
That's a black crappie there now.
Oh, yeah, right.
Yeah, speckle
right.
It is.
Yeah. Yep. No bars, right?
Yep. Mm-hmm.
Nice. Look where he's got it, too.
Yeah.
Just in the nose, boy. He's got a damaged eye, isn't he?
Yeah, it looks like he's one-eyed.
Yeah, it's like a cat.
Yeah.
but he could still find the bait.
Yeah, that's a good fish.
Poor him, now he goes in the live well. Look at his one eye here, I'm gonna show you this. Look at his eye. It's a one-eyed crappie. He's like a pirate.
Yeah.
There's a good one. And there he goes, into the box, join his friend. All it is, there's so many different ways we're catching them.
I'm this, a good guy.
Oh, yeah. See, that's what a good guy does. He puts the guys on the fish so the customers and clients catch them. He's caught so many crappie and bass in his life, he doesn't even care. But when the customer, like me, that's what I am today. Like a co-pilot customer, I'm catching them. I feel great. Like a crappie superstar. Let's keep going.
In here, we'll get it right quick.
Nice. Oh, I missed one right there. Do you believe that? I felt it all the way to my hand, and I had all that slack in the line. What the heck?
Good one.
A netter?
Might be.
Uh-oh.
If it's a crappie. It's a big old crappie.
Too. Is it?
Yeah, boy. Barely hooked. Good.
Oh, boy. Oh, is that a nice one, Roger? Yes, sir.
What about that?
Yeah, man.
Jig where it's at. It fell out of his mouth.
And you just changed the colors too, didn't you?
Yep. Turn that in live well right quick and I'll get it out of there.
Okay. Look at that, man. Fishing like Pickwick.
All right.
Good stuff, Roger. Look at the shoulders on him. All nice and thick. Big mouth. What do you say, crappie? You should have kept that yap closed, but now you got it caught and feed us.
I don't know about them Canadians kissing them.
We've had rain, drizzle, wind, doesn't matter what it is. We come out here to Alabama and have some fun with Roger, catching some crappie. And again, we do spider rigging, trolling, pulling cranks, bobbers, corks, whatever it is. But today, casting, just like a little crankbait, slow roll off the bottom. They're all over the water column. Roger talked about the lake coming up 3 feet in the last 3 days because of all the rain and stuff, but we're still catching them. We're having fun, and you can too, right here, Muscle Shoals, Alabama, Pickwick Lake, with my buddy Roger Stegall. Fishing right below the boat.
I've seen them sit there. Like I said, it looks like lasagna laying on the bottom.
Right.
They won't be separated from bottom. A lot of people think it's a stump.
Mm-hmm.
You drop that sucker down there, you'll see if it's a stump or not.
That's right.
And just go thump.
Because it did look like stumps.
Yeah. There's a fish right there. Get ready. There's a jig. Got him. Big one.
Oh, boy. You can swing this one?
I'll net it for you.
Okay. Wow, Roger. That is something else, huh?
Look at that.
They tell me that's not fun, man. Seeing them on the sonar and popping them. And look where they're getting it, too.
Yep. Right.
Look
top
at that.
Of my head.
You never miss those ones, do you? Boy.
Good fish.
That's a bad spot getting them in. That, yeah. Is it, the hole gets too big, huh?
Yeah, that's right. Or over in here in this lip right over in here.
Yes.
Over in that tender side. Yeah. But you get them in top of the head.
Yeah.
He's caught.
Awesome, boy. Awesome, man. This is now turning into fun. I mean, it was fun before, but when you see them like that,
yeah.
when you figuring it out, right? Because they're not chasing it that much anymore.
That's
and as soon
right.
as you say they're below the boat, and sometimes, what did you say again? They look like a stump.
That's right.
But it's not a stump.
It looks like lasagna. That's what it looks like. Laying on the bottom. That reddish looking color.
And it's these things.
That's right. I've caught too many of them doing that.
Nice stuff. Let's put them in here.
Start off casting, and we're throwing a 7-foot ultralight with a little 1,000 spinning reel with 6-pound line, and you throw a little 1/8-ounce jig head, put a wedge tail, and you try to keep it on there straight. You just put it on, just like this right here, just thread him on there and keep that wedge tail in line with your hook. Just bring it on there just like that right there and push it up on there. And that little tail just kicks like the dickens when you're swimming it. And we started off throwing this morning, casting, tight line is what we call it. And that's where I usually catch them. But today, the water, since yesterday, I guided yesterday, and since yesterday, the water's came up about a foot and a half, and it's continuous to rise today. And as you notice, there's a lot of trash on the water. So what we ended up doing, catching a lot of our fish, is we'd actually see them on my hummingbird up there. These hummingbird electronics is just unbelievable now. We'd see him on the hummingbird, drop it down straight to him, and catch a fish right under the boat. There's something right there. Got him. There you go.
Boy, did he hit that, Roger.
He liked it, didn't he?
Yes, sir. Right through the schnoz, too. But you couldn't have planned that better. You just finished saying, hey, there's one right there. Gotta love
it. That's the way to do it.
Yep. It's my jig going up and down. You see a fish, drop it down, hold it steady, and don't even do anything. These fish are like, they went from chasing it a bit this morning to now you gotta put it right on top of their nose, hold it, and then it's dunk, game on. Pretty fun stuff. Catching them with the jig. Got him? Atta boy, Roger.
Saw
good one?
Down there. Pretty good one.
Need a net?
Nah, I got it.
Oh, look at that. Nice crappie.
Good one. Look at that.
Right below the boat.
Good one. Saw him on the screen. I just kept fluttering it along and caught him. Good deal. That there's a good eater.
I'd say. And we just feather it on like this. You'll find where the head is there. The little tail vibrates. You come down. Just push it on to the jig head. Spin it around. And that's it. You're all ready to go. We only had about 4 hours. He came out this morning around 7:30, 8 o'clock. Time he got out, it's about 12:30 now. So you know what? Having a good day. A good feed of crappie. And once again, another lake on our show. Catching them with another guy who really knows, got them dialed in to how to catch them full time. Roger Stegall, big time. Let's go and try to catch a few more. Here we go. Come on.
There's one.
Got one?
Yeah.
Atta boy.
Got one. Good one.
Good one?
Yeah.
Netter?
Yeah.
A netter. All right. I like to hear that. Roger says it's a netter. It's a netter. Big crappie.
Big crappie. Ready?
Oh, look at him fight. Oh, that's a nice crappie. Atta boy, Roger. Oh, nice one, eh?
Oh, yeah.
Yes, sir. Wow.
Very nice to bait.
Atta boy. Atta boy.
Good fish. Look at that. Ooh, yeah. All right.
There's another one there, Roger.
You got one?
Yeah, a big one, too.
Big one. You need the net.
No, I'll scoop him. Let's see. Maybe. Yes.
Look at that.
Almost double header on Pickwick, huh?
I guarantee you, everyone right at the top of the head. Look
yes, sir.
Good fish.
Right on. Thanks, buddy. I saw, like you said, a brush pile or something.
Yeah.
All thick right there.
Yeah.
I put it down. Boom.
Boom.
So it's right over here somewhere, right?
Yeah, I know where it is.
Okay. Yeah, I'm sure you do. You brought us right out here. So, you know, it's like the smart old dog. He lets all the young dogs hunt all day long. And then he goes to where he knows the game is. I gotta catch some fish now.
See all this white hair? That's wisdom.
I ain't got any up here.
Yeah, I know, yours all cut out.
Makes me actually swim faster.
Oh, does it? No. I hope I ain't gonna be swimming down here in the future.
And if you would like to experience this awesome crappie fishing on Pickwick Lake with Roger, give him a call at 662-423-3869. Okay, you have some pre-spawn action, you had some late spring action in Alabama, and now it's about fall too. These little baits right here, this one's called the Dancer by Crappie Magnet. These little baits, all year long, even to the ice, vertical jigged, I know they will catch crappie. But in this scenario, we had it where the fish were pushing up bait late afternoon, late fall, and it was like something out of like an eco film. The crappie were just busting. So you want to keep that bait high in the water column. That's what we did. And that's what we're fishing paddle baits. Figure out where the crappie are. We knew they were busting bait, so we would cast them with small little jig heads, and that's key with fishing these little paddle baits. You don't want to go past the fish with a jig head that's too heavy. It's all relative to the size of the fish or the size of the bait, the depth you're fishing, the aggressiveness of the fish. So these fish were super aggressive near the surface. We threw it on a fin spin instead of a jig head to create more flash. We saw fish everywhere. We caught them one after another. It was insane. The Dancer was on fire. I mean, you talk about exciting. You know what? Two guys giggling like little schoolgirls, man, catching fish like crazy and stuff. But it, I mean, it got to a point where we're getting so excited that you throw your float and you're just waiting for it to go down. If it doesn't, you're seeing like 10 or 15 crappie about 15 feet to the right. So Josh picked up right away quickly the little fin spin with the new Dancer, the crappie magnet, and it was on big time. Like unreal, hey? It's unreal.
Ooh, sickening.
They must have a school of bait fish there. Like pushing them up, right?
They're literally tails are everywhere in front of us.
Yeah.
Look right there.
Yeah, look. Oh my God. Oh, this is all fish right here. This is all fish. All right here is fish. This is unbelievable, man. Right here, this is all crappie right here. Right here.
All right, I'm doing it.
What?
Fin spin.
Okay. You only got a couple minutes, but they should just crush it. Uh-oh. I got a good one.
Want that?
No, I'll squid. Oh, just a decent one. Oh. Ah, she's just a tenner. But I mean, this is not kidding, man. It is so loaded
there
right there.
First gas.
See?
Boom.
Yeah, man. I need to do that too, real quick. Real quick.
Boom! On the fin spin with the new Dancer. Look at that, man. Whoa, yeah.
See, we are.
Oh, it's go time, guys. The fish are boiling absolutely everywhere. It's pandemonium. Everywhere you look, it's push, push, push. And you're like, you're losing your mind trying to see where they are, but they're everywhere. So we put these suckers down, grab the horizontal baits here, the fin spin, the chartreuse Dancer. And let me tell you something, it was legitimately pandemonium. It was crazy. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 fish in a row. Bang, 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 you cast it out. 3 or 4 wines, bunk fish. It was just insane. I don't know what to tell you. This is the deal. Back to back on the fin. Oh boy, here we go.
Right here.
Oh, all right, we're on them. It's go time.
With the Dancer again, huh?
Oh dude, this new bait they got coming out, folks. Be ready for the Dancer. Look at this thing. Woo! Pure gold is what that is. Boom.
Unreal when they're feeding like that. Like whales,
dude,
eh?
This is epic. You can just see the little tails and the mouths coming out. You cast in it, you start reeling real slow, and bang!
Like right there?
Just like that, buddy. Wow.
Whoa, whoa. Wow. The Dancer gets a hog, dude.
Oh, right beside the boat. 3 for 3 here with it. Look at that. Eight beside the boat, 3 for 3.
Woohoo! Slap me in the face with the crappie. Slap nappy.
Hanging on.
Couple more, boo. Come on, couple more. Couple more. We will have our fee, Josh.
Oh, this man. This is sick.
Did I tell you this is sick?
This is sick.
The float is fun, but this is sick, isn't it?
This is just 10 times sicker. You don't even slap. Oh, man. Boing. Oh, I just went 3 for 3 in a row there. That was too sick.
Yes.
Is that 4? That's 4 in a row on the Dancer and the fin spin, boys and girls. Woo! Look at that. Tell ya. This. Oh, he almost went for a swim back. I don't think so. Oh, Carl's got a big one coming in here too. Look at this. Jeez. Absolute pandemonium. Let's go!
When people say what's pandemonium, they'll just show this in the dictionary one day. Huh?
Yeah. Look, and then you get all the little tangles, and you're like, ah, I gotta go, I need back out there.
Look at that little bait. Tiny little tail, I'll show it to you. But on the fin spin, you just gotta keep putting it out. I got braid, I think Josh has got braid. Nano. And just in front of the boat, and I mean slow rolling, dude, right below the surface. They're right up high pushing the bait. And when they see that little spin and that little kick and tail,
that
man, they
vibration,
eat.
Maybe.
It's just eat. There's no... Yes. You know, it's very, very important to be prepared because, you know, when there's a frantic bite going on, you want the rods ready. So we had a couple float rods each put aside with different depths fishing. We had different fin spins, the Pro Series fin spin. But something about that new little Dancer, we just cast it about 20 feet and slow rolled it as soon as it hit the surface. These fish were busting bait right on the surface. You couldn't even go slow enough. I mean, it doesn't matter if we ripped it. We're just slowly going. That little tail kicking was unreal. You'd hook a fish,
lose a fish, and just keep reeling while you're giggling and hook another fish. Some of the biggest crappie I was hooking into were about 2 feet from the boat.
Wow. Did we move off a bit?
No, I got another one. This is a good one. This is a good one. This is a nice
hit. Can you get him okay?
Yeah. Not even that nice. Just crushed it. But Carl, if you look back here, I just saw about a 50 of them in there.
Okay.
And behind us again, look. Okay. Oh my gosh. This is insanity.
Another one.
Look at that. Now I just went 5 casts in a row.
Oh, I just lost a good one, dude.
Like 5 casts in a row. What else do you want? Woo! Look at the pile of them over here. Look at this. Look at the tails.
I know. Oh, it's unbelievable, dude, what we got right in front of us here. Wow.
This is sickening.
Oh, I lost them.
This is just sickening.
Wow. Another one. Oh, my God, dude. It doesn't matter. You lose. You just keep bringing the bait in. Look at this one, Josh.
Oh, donk.
Look at this.
This is too much.
Look. Look at that. The bait is like, oh, my God, dude. Unreal. Unreal. Crappie fishing in early October on a perfect, beautiful night. And we're throwing the dancer, the fin spin, and we are having the time of our life.
Oh, man. Wow, let me tell you something. Had I not been here on this trip, hanging out with these cool guys, man, let me tell you, I would have never had the chance in my lifetime to experience such a phenomenon, let alone within driving distance of the GTA here. This is insane.
You had that flurry there.
I was sick. I tell you, one bait I will never, ever forget for a long time to come. That dancer is going to be in this box every day for the rest of my life.
You tell me that was not exciting. I mean, it was unreal. You know, casting and casting, the sun's going down. We want to keep going, but we want to get back to our resort safely, obviously. But it's just like, wow, just one more cast. Because they were absolutely psychotic as that sun went down, coming up, pushing up bait. So think about late fall, big black crappies, man. They go psychotic and school up like there's no tomorrow in late fall like they do in spring.
Okay, last but not least, early summer fishing a weedy hump in the middle of the lake and casting and drifting over crappie schools. Post-spawn, ganged up, off the shoreline, but these fish, when you find them, you can smash them. And we did on this afternoon with the little paddle-tail baits again. And this was about casting it out, controlled cadence, bringing it back slow and let them eat it. But we caught more fish just putting this bait, looking at our sonar, seeing where the fish were above the weeds, on the side of the weeds, hold the bait below the boat, and just lift and slowly drop. Controlled lift and drop. The crappie could not resist the little paddle-tail baits.
Except for that one.
Hey, nice one, buddy.
Hey, that's a cool way to fish, dude. I'm watching him on the sonar, watching, and it's just loaded. Look at, you got to see this. Come on up here real quick. Look at that. I'm going to show you this. Look.
I got a real nice one, buddy.
You got a good one?
Oh, yeah.
Big. Look at this. Those are all crappies right there. It's a fine line of using the right size jig head and too heavy. Now you say, okay, you want to be able to cast where those fish are. Well, they're moving around on this hump out here in the middle of the lake. But you got to get their attention, get it through the school, but keep it in the zone so they're going to eat it. So you say, whoa. So it's very simple. For this, there's not much waves. If it was really wavy, it might be tough. If it was calm, probably could go even a smaller jig head and keep it in that zone even longer. But that little 1/16th is the deal. Smaller jig head, have faith and let it fall, because when they see it and that little tail's kicking, it just provokes the strikes. Don't rush it. They'll show you how they want it. Right there. Whoa. I think so. It's putting a good bend. Boy, is this a crappie or bluegill, dude?
What?
Oh.
Dude, you need the net?
Let's see.
Oh. Whoa.
Hey, you talk about sharp little hooks. Look at it. There's no way that's coming out. And it's past that sensitive spot. Look at that. You always worry sometimes about, oh, crappie and stuff like that. But I'm going to show you, look at that. And look what it catches me. A nice crappie sitting out 19 feet of water suspended with a school of friends. And now we found you, and now we're going to catch you, and then we're going to eat you. Thank you. Go on in there, boy. Love it. You think there's schools of fish right there? Look at that. See all those streaks? Those are all crappie right there. There's our waypoint. 10:22 in the morning. Look at that, sitting over 18 feet of water. All suspended fish right there. Here's exactly what we're doing. I'm watching for fish on the sonar, looking for those arcs. Reel in, cast out, and do nothing. You say, do nothing. Nope. I just tighten up the line a bit. You got the wind blowing against us, so you get a little bit of a bow in the line. And I'm having faith that that jig is falling through those suspended fish. Once in a while, as the wind's pushing the boat back, that little tail is moving. I lift up and I drop. I'm letting that jig just fall through where I see those suspended fish and drop. That's it. Real simple stuff, man. And there's no missing it. You feel thunk, like right there. I just missed one. Wow. Just let it go down. Watch it. You can actually put your finger right here. You'll be able to feel those little soft bites if you want to. But that B&M, Sam Super Sensitive, there's a reason why it's called super sensitive. And you're fishing like this, and you feel those little thump, sharp bites. It's incredible. But a simple way to fish, but so much fun. Right there. Whoa, is that crappie? What is, dude? Look at that. Yeah, for sure. For sure. I got to keep attention on. Whoa. Hey?
That's the one I missed.
The slow drift. The slow drift. See?
Oh, yeah.
Look how you got it, too. Isn't that awesome? That is an awesome way to fish, dude. Awesome way to fish, I tell you. Just holding the bait like that. You're drifting by, and I look down the sonar. What do I see? Bait fish. And that little bait goes right through it. Look at that. Beautiful slab, man. Big fins, a mouth. Hey? Oh, I love these fish, man. Wow. Look what we got right there. Just a nice meal for ourselves and a cameraman and the people at the lodge. The crappie have provided for us once again. So when you want to go out and catch crappies and they're not going in the shallows, come on out. Don't be shy to go out in the deep water. Find some, maybe some weeds and different things, contour, sometimes just bait. Fish with faith. That's what it takes out here, faith. Let this bait go down, wait. The right rod, sensitive bites with the B&M. Thank you, Sam, because you're super sensitive and you made our day. Thanks for watching. We'll see you guys next time. Man, that was fun, eh? Fishing with something different. The little paddle-tailed, little crappy soft plastics. I want to offer three different people who watch our video to experience exact same crappie fishing with paddle baits. I've got three packs of the crappie magnet, little dancer, little paddle tail bait, some of the jig head. So three people, all you have to do is watch the video, comment below on the video, and subscribe to our channel, and I'll send three of you the exact same baits that you saw on this episode. And for one person, the Flex Fit cap, okay? The Crappie Machine logo. Flex Fit, medium, large, extra large. You tell me your hat size, you tell me why you like the video, you tell me why you might potentially use paddle tail baits like the dancer to catch crappie, and I will send one person this exact hat, just like I wear, just like we wear, the Crappie Machine. Thanks for watching. Hope you subscribe. Hope you like our content, and I hope to see you next time.